Okay, so the purpose of this video is just to do a brief recap of the information that you should have learned about position versus time graphs, or sometimes they're referred to as distance time graphs. When we look at a position time graph or a distance time graph, I want to first point out, that we have the position or the distance or some variable measured in meters listed over on the y-axis side of our graph. On our x-axis, we have our time that is measured in seconds. Now, our time is only going to be positive values because this is a scalar value, where there is no such thing as negative time. Scalar values are always going to be expressed as positives because we are just saying how much of something we have. When we look at the y-axis and we see that we have both positive and negative values for our position, in this case, we are saying how far our object is, or where that location is from position zero, so what that distance is, but it also has a direction where positive, and if you look at the bottom of the screen, I have kind of created a little map, if you would, which shows my 0 meter mark to be the location when I'm standing at point A and point D. And then you can see in the green, that is the positive side of my map, where I am located to the right or to the east of that reference or 0 meter mark, which is our reference point. And then the, we'll call it orange side of my map, is going to be the negative side as far as my position values go, where I am now located to the left or to the west of that 0 meter mark. So when we look on a graph, the y-axis has positive and negative values, where the positive y-axis, or some students like to say the top half of the graph, represents a positive position. I am now located to the right or to the east. On the negative side of the graph, this means I am now located to the west or to the left. Okay, so for our position time graph, positive values are to the right or east, negative values are to the left or west. It's really important that we get this positive negative meaning. Negative 5 is not less than 5. All right, let's talk about what this variable actually means. If I'm measuring something in meters, I'm saying how far away, what that distance is. So if I say in math class that I have 0 and then I have a negative 5 is less than 0, let's take that and apply it to our physics class. You are trying to tell me that I have a distance less than 0 meters, where zero would represent no distance. So you're trying to say that I have a value less than 0, less than nothing. In physics, that doesn't exist, okay? So you need to understand the significance of the positive negatives when we are talking about position. It is there for directional purposes. All right, now, here I have some information. I know there's lots on the screen. Let's just focus on what's written in brown for just a moment. If we are talking about the distance traveled, and I did three different segments here, from point A to point B, that's 5 meters. B to C is 0 meters. A to D is 10 meters. Here's what we're doing. Distance is scalar. The direction does not matter. So we are simply counting all of the motion that has taken place. So for my distance, if my object is moving, then that distance counts. So when I get to the last example of AD, I traveled 5 meters, I traveled 0 meters, and then I traveled an additional 5 meters. So I'm simply going to add all of those up. Whether I went right or left, I'm standing on the positive or negative side, none of that matters for distance. You just add everything up. Now in red, I am now discussing displacement, where the proper way to determine displacement is by finding the difference between my starting and ending point. So the definition of displacement is change in position, where we symbolize change with a little triangle, which we will call delta. That is the name of the triangle. And anytime we are taking the change of a variable, we will always subtract so that we say final minus initial for that variable. So you can see from my written work here that I've listed, I guess we can call it an equation. It was really just an explanation of how to find the change in the distance, or the change in the position. So delta D is always going to be final position minus initial position. So for segment AB, it's just 5. BC, it is 0 because my position was the same. So I would be subtracting a position of 5 minus a position of 5. So there is no change in position there. If I look at segment AD, notice that that is also 0. Now, my object actually moved, but my position A and my position D are actually both at the same location. If I look at the little map that I have added below the graph here, A and D are listed both at the 0 meter mark. So that's why we have a displacement of 0 from final to initial position. Location AE is actually what I currently have written out on the screen here over on the left-hand side. I have position E is a negative 5, so my final position is a negative 5, minus position A is 0, so minus 0. Negative 5 minus 0 gives me a displacement of negative 5 meters, which means that I am located 5 meters in the negative direction from where I started. So if I look at the little map that I drew earlier, I am now on the orange side of the map, which means I'm to the left or to the west. And these are going to be represented with negative values, but you can see on my little ruler that I drew out, I am only 5 meters away. I am just located to the left, okay? So this is the difference between distance and displacement and how we pull that data off of the graph. If we look at what I have highlighted in blue, now I'm starting to talk about slope, and that's going to be the bottom of the set of questions here on the slide. So remember, slope is rise over run. On our graph, our rise has a label. This is going to be our how far in meters. Our run has a label, and this is going to be our time in seconds. So when I go to calculate rise over run, I'm saying how far over time. I'm saying distance over time. I'm taking meters divided by seconds. So my answer when I calculate slope is going to be meters per second, and this is our unit for speed. So on a position time or a distance time graph, the slope of the line is going to represent the speed of my object. The last couple of things that we're discussing on this graph are kind of telling us, number one, how our speed can be quickly interpreted, how we can have a general understanding of the speed by looking at the slope. So if we have a steady slope, meaning that I can take my pencil, I can lay it down on top of the graph, and my pencil covers the entire line, or it covers maybe a segment of that of the slope, then that segment has a constant speed, meaning I can pick any location along that line and the slope is going to be the same for all of the locations on that line. So here I would say that my object is moving at a constant speed for segment AB. My object is moving at a constant speed for segment CE. I would like to address BC. I would want you to interpret that as my object is at rest. I have a speed of 0. So if I'm asking you for where is the object moving with a constant speed, then we would typically identify this as a moment where my object is at rest. Okay, so from here, from this moment forward, that's how we're going to answer that question. If we calculated our slope, rise over run, I just kind of filled in the numbers. And so this is showing you that we have a slope value, AKA a speed of 5 meters per second for AB, 0 meters per second for BC, and C through E, the entire slope was the same. So at every moment along that line, we have a speed of 5 meters per second. if the speed were to change, I drew some curved lines over here to the right of number 3, and we reviewed that with our graph basics before. Now, in math class, we should be able to identify positive and negative slope values based off of the tilt of the line. We're gonna go ahead and do the same for that today. So AB has a positive slope, CE has a negative slope. Down at the bottom, the very last question, number 6, what is the average speed for this graph? Remember that our speed, or specifically our average speed, is going to be the total distance covered divided by the total time that it took to travel that distance. So for this question, they didn't give me a specific segment on the graph because I'm using the entire graph. When it says average speed, that means all of the motion is being considered, and we're performing one calculation to say, in general, overall, we could say, for the most part, we traveled at this speed because we went this far in this much time. So I'm going to take the total distance of 10 meters, and I'm going to take the total time of 5 seconds. So for this graph, my average speed would be 2 meters per second.